comes out, but you've got your posh bit, which I haven't got. You can see the pads are on the back. All you do is pull them out, rip them out, and then you've got a lot of a longer lead in there to go to the patient, like my one has. Okay. You have your AED starter pack, which has got your scissors in, all your bits and bobs. So somebody is called 999, okay, and I'm doing the compressions. So I'm doing all of this.
Sorry.
Like so. Yeah, I've called for help. Help! And my good friend and colleague here, who's just been whacking a few balls around a tennis court, has run to the clubhouse and bought the defib out. I'm going, I'm getting really knackered. Can you turn it on and do something, please? Thank you. So if you know what to do, just crack on and do it. We don't say you have to wait.
Follow the voice prompt card.
Got the rule this time.
Remove all clothing from chest and stomach. Rip clothing if necessary.
Yeah, I'll carry on then.
Take out the pads from the bottom of the device. Tear open the pads packaging.
Oh, he's on it though. Okay, cool.
Do not touch the patient. Analyzing heart rhythm. Shock advised. Stand clear. Press the flashing orange button. Shock delivered. Begin CPR now. Press the flashing blue eye button for first.
Because I've breathed into it.
Second.
And then carry on.
System shutting down.
You okay? There you go. You okay with that? Well, I'll just demonstrate something. Clearly, most people don't collapse onto a barbecue table, do they? So I just want to demonstrate the patient generally being something of that position. Okay. So what I would suggest is obviously you come down to the side. And the way you do compressions is that you make your arms into like a piston, okay? So the heel of your hand goes into the centre of their chest, like so. The other one goes on top. You can lock your hands, you can do that, I don't really mind. But what is really difficult, or make it difficult for you, sorry, make it really tight, is if you do this. Don't do that. You want to do this. Because then you're locking your body weight.
So you're locking it
up? Yes, absolutely locking them. Yeah, it's a piston. Not using your muscles, because that's really knackering and tiring. If you do that, all I'm doing is rocking. But I'm rocking down, and don't do this either, because then I'm pushing that way and not down. You want to go straight away down, because your heart is between your breastbone and your spine. And every time you push down, to push it out, that blood, and back in. These 5-6 centimeters down, okay. And once you've done 30, if you feel confident, all you do is tip the head back, squeeze soft part of the nose, nice big seal, and watch the chest rise. As you can see, I did it nice and slowly. I didn't do a lot of people who go, because that's not how you breathe, is it?
No.
You breathe nice and passively. Yeah, so nice. I know your heart is going to be doing all of this, but even if you don't do that, just remember to do that, because that's really important. Staying alive, staying alive.